One happy day, you're receiving tons of love messages from your cute girlfriend, just like you usually do. Suddenly, someone, maybe your girlfriend's ex-boyfriend, tries to hack and read your WhatsApp conversation. But thanks to encryption, he fails. Now imagine, you're receiving tons of love messages from your cute girlfriend, just like you usually do. Without encryption, your girlfriend's ex-boyfriend tries to hack and read your WhatsApp conversation again. Except for now, he can read almost everything. By definition, encryption is the process of decoding messages and information in such a way that only authorized personnel can read it. B, that does not prevent interception, but it prevents the interceptor from accessing the messages. In other words, anyone without the key cannot read the data as it's altered so that you cannot read the message. For example, you have a parcel containing valuables inside and you want to give it to your brother that lives very far away from you. So, you lock it with a key similar to what your brother has and post it to him. On the journey, other people can still touch and hold the parcel, but cannot open it as they don't have the right key to unlock it. Only the brother can unlock the locked parcel as he has the right key. That is similar to encryption, whereby only the person with the right key can access the encrypted messages or information. Other uses include facilitation of secret communication used by military and governments, protecting information within many kinds of civilian systems, and a lot more. And by a lot, I mean really a lot. According to Computer Security Institute report in 2007, 71% of companies utilize encryption for some of their data in transit, and 53% utilize encryption for some of their data in storage, and the percentage increases each year. There are two types of encryption. One of the encryption is the symmetric key. So in symmetric key, you have the same key for the encryption and decryption. Basically, the two parties need to have the same key in order to have a secure communication. So in practice, the symmetric key encryption is basically like a shared secret between two parties where they have the same keys and they have to make sure that they are kept safe with each other. The second type of encryption is the public key. So the public key, or the asymmetric encryption, is a cryptography system where you are given two pairs of keys, one public and one private. So basically, this serves to function when you encrypt a message, with a public key, only the owner of the private key can access and or decrypt the message. For this example, Azwani wants to deliver a message to Iskandar saying that Mr. Tiaga is very handsome. So, she encrypts the text so that it becomes a ciphertext, a text that cannot be read without the proper key or information. However, Jawad, an unexpected stranger, tries to decrypt the text. He does not have the right key to decrypt it.
One eternity later.
He fails and fails.
A few moments later.
But here, Iskandar arrives only to find a ciphertext. So, he calls Azwani to get the right key to decrypt the text. Now, he knows that Mr. Tiaga is very handsome. Now, after talking about all the superiority of encryption, can it still be hacked? Introducing Professor Drew Soni from Stanford University.
This here are a list of standardized encryption specifications used by everyone from your average Joe at home to a businessman in a corporation center to an intelligence officer to an intelligence agency trying to topple the Syrian regime. The EES, followed by the military digit number, represents the largest key size in bits. That would mean your data will be encrypted in 128 ones or zeros. Mathematically speaking, there are two possible possibilities, being one or zero, multiplied by, the power of the key size being 128, will result in a total of 3.40 times 10 to the power of 38 possible combinations. The larger the number, or the key size, the larger the number of possible combinations, making your data more secure. Now, in theory, if you wish to break said combination, you will only require 50% of the combinations to be exhausted in order for you to break the combination. So, how long would, say, one take to break any of these combinations written here on the board? Well, in theory, say you have 1 billion GPUs connected together to a network, each GPU capable of encrypting or rather engaging 2 gigaflops of calculations. That's equivalent to 1 billion calculations per second. Cumulated, you'll have 2 quintillion keys per second being calculated, or in this case, decrypted. Annually, that would mean 6.31 times 10 to the power of 25 keys per year. Now, that's pretty or stupid machine. With that in mind, we take half the possible number of combinations divided by the number of keys that could be broken in a year, and we will get the approximate time for each combination to be broken. Now, the AES 128, the smallest I've written here, we take an approximate 2.70 times 10 to the power of 12 years. That's a very long time. The largest key, AES 256, would have 2.18 times 10 to the power of 50 years. Now, in theory, the sun has 5 times 10 to the power of 9 years to live. Compared to the time taken to break, say, AES 256, why not that far? And AES 128. Encryption standardized, which takes 2.70 times 10 to the power of 12 years, the sun will be long gone, so will be the earth, your home, and you'll be still at hard work trying to decrypt a simple 8 combination password. Only find out password was password all the time.
In conclusion, encryption is very important because it keeps our data safe from anyone we don't want to see it. By using encryption, we can avoid malicious hackers from siphoning in our communication and listening to what we say, it'll be harder for them rather than having a plain text. So, managing encryption may be difficult, but we cannot ignore it completely. Encryption may be difficult, but it's worth the effort.